Do you feel like you're ready to have a significant other, or the no would be no, I feel like I've got more in me that needs to be fixed before I'm ready to have a significant other?
I guess my answer would be, because I'm a perfectionist, I would, like, there is endless amounts of things that I would need to be fixed, or I feel like I would want to be fixed before I did.
Yeah.
But I guess I personally am ready. In my heart,
I like that. I like that.
In my heart, I'm ready. On God's timing, but in the meantime, I'm fixing everything I possibly can.
That's awesome. I love that, bro. Well, blown away. That's great, bro. That's what I like to hear. I don't think that there's ever a time where you're really like you feel like fully ready, but I feel like it's good to know that there's always things to fix. That's awesome. That's what I wanted to know. Damage is done now. I'm out of control. How did you get to me?
Close your eyes. All right, I know it's weird. Take my hand. I don't want you to stumble over anything. You can close, and I'll tell you when to open them. Almost there. Oh, watch out. I got you.
It feels like we're going downhill.
Trust me, we're good. Come on, you're good. Come on. Come on.
Oh my God. I just tripped over something.
You're good. I got you. I know this is super weird. We're literally like best friends. We hang out all the time. But I just wanted to know something really quick. Allison Shinaki, will you be my very first Valentine that I've ever had?
What in the world is this? Are you serious?
You've never had a Valentine. I've never had a Valentine. I think it would be only fitting that we were each other's very first Valentine. Would you like to be my Valentine?
Yes, I would love to be your Valentine. I thought you were asking someone else.
You thought I was asking somebody else?
So far, they have run tests on me. They haven't found anything wrong, so that's good. But we're gonna continue to stay here and figure out what's going on.
What did you do now?
What are you doing here?
What did you do to yourself?
Long story short, I have been having chest pains for the past couple of months. They kind of started getting worse the second time I got COVID back in December. And I'm not gonna lie, like, it's a little scary when it happens. It gets worse at night. And what happens is I get really heavy in my chest and it feels like somebody's sitting on me. And then I'll literally feel sharp pains all through the left side of my chest, all through my back. And it'll go down my left arm, feeling like someone's squeezing it, and it'll make my arm go completely numb. I first started realizing this because I wasn't really feeling like myself, and my whole entire left hand was swollen for a couple of months. I thought maybe I had just jammed my hand in a door or something because I'm really clumsy. I mean, put in the comments if y'all are the same, but it didn't go away, and it honestly just kept getting more and more swollen.
How about we try this?
Boyfriend and girlfriend right now.
No.
Boyfriend and girlfriend eventually. You're not saying no. You have to say something.
Austin is the only one that will ever deal with me and my issues.
I'm a huge, like, overthinker in my head. Like, I'm constantly, like, overthinking everything. Like, I cannot just, like, relax. My mind is constantly, like, overthinking, and I'm so, like, I'll be in a good mood, and then all of a sudden, like, I'll be in a bad mood all of a sudden because I'm, like, thinking in my mind so much. And my biggest fear with Austin is that one day he's just going to be like, I'm done. Because he's just over it. He's just over how many times I'm just in my head. Now my baby's dancing, but she's dancing with another man. And that man is me.
Well, I'll make it up to you. All of the been driving back and forth from my home to Noah's house. I've always kind of been afloat, almost living out of my car per se. So I've never really had a space that I could call my own that I could work in as well. And it finally happened. I have my own space now.
What the crap? This is my house. What even is this?
Guys, this has been a secret that I've been wanting to tell you forever. I have finally moved out. One of the craziest parts about this is we're right next door to Allie. Which, I mean, is it weird? Kind of, maybe a little bit, but I literally moved next door. How crazy is this?
We'd be good together, don't you think?
No.
Why?
Because I'll break your heart.
Maybe I'll break yours.
Nobody breaks my heart.
My gosh, I just love your matching dresses.
Really?
No!
How he takes care of me when I'm sick.
Hello.
What are you doing?
I brought you coffee, but you are super sick and and fun stuff and everything, so. Wait, slow. Okay, do not move.
Are you serious,
yeah,
Austin?
Yeah, I'm serious right now.
Are you dead serious?
Yes, I'm serious right now. You're amazing, awesome. I'll see you later, okay?
Got my own found, need security in the club. All they woofing on the net. I thought you was a thug, I ain't.
Ever overprotective, so why?
Tell the truth, mother.
A little bit. I am a little bit. Okay, a lot.
When?
But
proof.
When? Okay, if you're not feeling good, right?
Yeah.
There's multiple times. I'll just show all my cards tonight. There's multiple times. If you're not feeling good, I usually can tell, like,
girl,
immediately when something is off, like, even the slightest, I'll feel it for some reason.
You do.
And if somebody else can't, like, regardless of who it is, if somebody else can't, like, take a hint, I get ticked off for you because I want you to feel good so bad. So I'm like, I know that you need your rest and that, like, whatever they're doing is, like, a little too much for you. So everything inside of me is like, okay, you just need to chill. Cause that bothers me for sure. You see me in hindsight, tangled up with you all night, burning it down. Keep calling me, why do I feel like this? What happened to me?